主内兄弟姊妹好早起平安。现在咱来开始今仔早起的主日崇拜会，圣餐主日崇拜会。诗篇二十八篇第六到第七节，耶和华是应当称颂，因为伊听了我恳求的声音。耶和华是我的力量，是我的盾牌，我心内倚靠伊，就得帮助。所以我心中欢乐，我必用诗歌颂赞伊。现在请大家三甲起立来唱咱头一首诗，上帝创造地段的画面。上帝所创造的万物，最最起来有乐音声。哈利路亚，哈利路亚，上帝的爱无穷无尽，是安舒服天的万物。这一个开始的祈祷，亲爱的父亲，感谢你，满心感谢你，给我们这个机会，能来这里聚集，能有自由，能来敬拜你。我们特别敲念，我们请弟兄姊妹，特别是我们的宣教士，在无上所在，无这个自由，能来享受，来特别敲念的。虽然恳求你，虽然因有在安尼的情形，无通。自由人通来传讲你的信息，主恳求主你继续调因三角地咧，互因聪明智慧有法通，伫无用无上方法人来做一个美好的见证，带阔阔阔侪人来亲近你。阮将今仔早起崇拜会对头到落尾交托伫你手中，特别为阮的讲员来祈祷，无论伫用文堂、用伫牧师，还是伫文堂。那单纯想张罗要传讲信息，主恳求主你继续叫因三合地咧，鼓舞因的嘴子，可以所传讲的信息，无论伫用文堂和文堂，毋是对家己来，但是主对主你来， 阮国即摆将阮每一个交托伫你手中，求主你继续保守、看顾、带领。安尼祈祷，靠主圣名求，阿门。各位请坐。咱来继续吟诗，阿罗咱的上帝，咱来唱第二首诗，清早起夜何正。起立，唱第三节。家乡天也好晴，做工甘愿着无，虽然拄着危险，硬扛半路山。故乡啊，最清楚，叫做就来支援，特别欢喜迎新，故乡小到来，故乡小到来。有关纪念，请我阿国长老来教咱目睹。
阿拉头三个祈祷，有着万面主宰，阮的上帝，阮的天父，主你是信实的，你是可靠的，你也是慈悲仁爱的上帝。主阮今仔日坦然无惊，接着耶稣基督的宝血，伫遐的下边，互阮通坦然无惊，来伫天父的宝座顶，一只向你求恩。天父上帝，求你听阮的祈祷，阮今仔日的聚会，搁一摆求主帮助，求圣灵伫阮中间运行做工，互阮通伫遐安静，伫主的面头前来敬拜，来听主你所要互阮的话语，互阮伫遐的生命得到转变。所以阮也为着今仔日伫英文部的中间，就是阮的黄立牧师，伊所要带领的九点到十一点的聚会，求主啊保守啊带领伊。伊是做要讲的，就是伫遐发动这个福音的工作，完发动主你神国的降临，主给你保守带领因的两堂的聚会。主阮也为着阮伫遮，今仔日也真正欢喜，也通得到陈准修长老伫阮的中间这个五克力伫遐通推伊翻译，主给你保守，互因所讲所翻译的一切，拢甲阮同心，互阮每一位通遮好好。来领受主你遮道马可福音第四章第一节到二十节所要对阮讲的话，互阮每一句通听，得到主你的搁一摆的鼓励，得到主你一摆的提升，互阮每一位通爱尊敬来伫遐做受五国的工作，互阮通听，四界通也争取传福音，互阮做中心 的人，互阮通伫遐听候主你甲阮同在，听候主你过来的时阵，互阮通将福音传遍伫大家角落。主为着阮现在的宣教士也来到伫主的面头前来祈祷，为着 Elizabeth 交因牵手，就是这个 Zachariah 的工作，因这对夫妇伫一个回教堂小组的工作中，但是这个国家实在是无爱欢喜福音传到因遐，所以是一个真艰苦做的工厂。求主特别保守带领因带因，互因伫个角落的时阵，一个小岛的中间，唔单单因伫遐要带领，甚至还佫有三个其他的导师，因也中伫遐做监督的工作。求主拢伫遐一步一步引带带领，互因忠心到底，互因有聪明智慧。这款的情形的中间，主你的确互因有从带领帮助因，互因有力量，互因伫遐接着天父的看顾保守。主，阮深爱感谢你，就是Elizabeth 这个阮的宣教士，伊顶一摆耳仔有发炎，但是现在已经完全得到主你的医治恢复。主，求你帮帮助，互因这对夫妇有勇敢的身躯，通伫遐担当起因的工作。主，阮知影讲最近你接着你的引带，因伫一个移民局伫遐的所在，拄着四位的菲律宾人伫个所在。受捆绑的时阵，有一位是伊拉克人，拢是回教徒，但是因有机会参加因分享福音，甚至因也愿意接受主，这个是你奇妙的行为，是主你所行的神迹。其中有一位，另外伫一个所在底下，因也愿意分享了福音，底下也证实。主，阮感谢你，这个人常常也答应伊，逐礼拜继续要来聚会。虽然伊是个亲信的、热心的回教徒，但是主你的灵、你的工作是伟大的，主你的信息是可靠的。主，阮为着因的工作来感谢你。主，最近因的工作也伫遐看到有一个新加入，伊伫因的团队的基督徒。主，求你也保守因，主求因继续伫遐。望你的号召，继续伫遐扩开、扩阔因的产量，通伫遐得到修行30倍、60倍、100倍。主讲只有我靠天父上帝恩典，圣灵保护主伫遐甲民众在所做的工作。主啊，有听到因最近伫附近另外一个所在有设立一个幼稚园的工作伫遐有30几位是回教徒的主日学生。主求你也保守这个工作。主，阮听讲为着经济问题，因欠债伫下年，主除非你的稳定搁伫遐，你的旨意伫遐要按因继续做，主给你供给因的需要，因为因无法通伫遐继续支持，怀有伫阮的先生，主阮就将这个阮的问题提交，写交予阮的主耶稣基督，求主伫遐继续，予因有机会通亚进，阮将一切拢摕伫你的手中，阮现在为着伫阮的伊斯米亚的工作，阮本堂伫六月初十到七月初一的每一个拜六早起，因为着在八岁到十二岁的囡仔，通伫遐上拜六时，每一拜一礼拜一拜，通伫遐来带领遮囡仔用运动，用即羽球的运动的训练班来吸引因，甚至因望即几位新参加的新加入的，通得到听到主你的话语，通明白你，通接受你，唔单伫健康身体方面得到主你的保养，互因伫灵性方面，互遮囡仔伫细汉的时阵，通得到明白主你的话，通伫遐将来真多主你的工人伫遐继续这个亚正的工作，主阮将一切拢摕伫你的手中，现在阮也为着伊多比亚这个国家，主给你继续保守带领。主，阮感谢你，虽然这个国家也是大多数是属地会较多，但是20%是基督徒。主，因也是有真多是挂名的基督徒，但是至少20%是福音派的基督徒。主，阮看到这个工作，因是一个铜墙铁壁的真正坚固的一个区域。回教徒要怎入来？伫几世纪的浪中间，主你的福音、你的真实，也阁是也徛在。主给你继续保护这个犹太人的工国家，因的工作，特别在底下的年轻的人，因的人口差不多70%是30岁以下的青年人。 主给你，和因我通针对遮青年人来做工，因为遮青年人是将来，唔望因通伫遐熟伫教会，唔望因的信心同款坚固，巴不得有人通伫遐好好来做训练遮青年人的工作，唔遮青年人传福音，唔遮青年人来继续也成绩。主，阮将一切拢摕伫你的手中，主给你，和因通增加怀听主的侍奉你的，通和你的国度更加宽阔。主，阮为着因啊，这个国家最近常常拄着回教徒底下诶攻击，甚至回教徒用真侪经济的方法来帮衬创一个社会的工作，用金钱来刷现金，或者啊吸引人通归回伫啊因回教徒的来源去。所以回教徒现在真正啊大胆咧做工作，甚至有诶是用侮辱用啊。用个真正强迫的方法，伫遐来阻止住伫遐的教会，阻止你伫遐要做传福音的工作，主求你败坏魔鬼伫遐所做的工作。阮一切拢交托伫阮的天父的手中，主你是信实的，你的慈爱永远长存。主你的主耶稣啊，伫遐替阮顶死的工作，阮今仔伫圣餐礼拜时阵，搁做少年主你的大听，甚至啊伫遐少年主你爱万万。人拢得救，主将一切拢交托伫天父上帝手中。阮安尼祈求，上主耶稣基督的圣尊名求，阿门。
请大家由阮起立，阮要读上帝话语。今仔早起的经文记载伫马可福音第四章，阮要对第一节读到第九节。马可福音第四章，阮要对头第一节到读到第九节。现在我们来三个读。耶稣搁伫海边教训人，有真侪人到伊遐聚集，伊只得上船坐落，船伫海内，众人拢靠近海，徛伫岸顶。耶稣就用譬喻教训伊真侪道理。伫教训之间，对因讲：恁听，有一个夜精的出去夜精。夜的时阵，有落伫路边的白鸟来食尽了；有落伫土浅石头地顶的土，既然无深，发苗地紧，日头出来一晒，因为无根就孤单了；有落伫刺皮内的刺皮顶起来，将伊砍掉就无结实；阁有落伫火土内的。就发生中断，结实有三十倍，有六十倍，有一百倍。国讲有耳仔通听的，就应当听。国多谢，就国贵请坐。今仔早起的题目是夜静甲修行，将其他时间交予咱的讲员，但准上长老，请五家里长老来翻译。
兄弟姊妹平安。
Peace to all of you。
咱今仔日后要讲到耶稣，伊有讲真侪譬喻中间，但是其中一个第一基本的，就是咧讲到这个夜精的譬喻。
Jesus have given several parables during his ministry in earth, and the most basic one is the sowing and reaping parable。
以后呢，这个夜精的譬喻，我咱会讲到有四款的土。
The parable of the sower has four kinds of soil.
学生问耶稣，这个什么意思？
The disciples asked Jesus, "What is the meaning of this?"
耶稣就讲到有四款人的心，因怎样回应，所以啊，的经旨就是上帝的话，上帝的道理。
So Jesus told them that there are four kinds of heart.That the people responds to if they hear the gospel of Christ.
以后呢，咱会讲到这个好的土，这个好的心，然后反应的心，有什么款的特别的独特，还是伊的性质，会通来帮助人。
Then we are going to talk about the characteristics of the responsive heart.
然后咱会讲到圣经，哦，咱有经三个 耶稣本身伊所教导的，就是咧讲到亚种甲收割，一寡原则。
Then thirdly, we are going to have some biblical teachings on sowing and reaping.
伫咱未开始，咱来阿头三甲祈祷。
Let's pray.
亲爱的天父上帝，我一拜，满心无落感谢，因为你是掌管的，你是阮的上帝，自由拥有的。是荣耀的王，荣耀的主，我们每一个人应该在你的面前谦卑下来，来听你的话语，因为我们靠自己是不会做什么，每项都是要依靠你，求你增加我们每个人的信心，你也给我们的心的反应，你的话语，给我们的人会得到帮助，我们从早起，起你长老和我所要传的信息再一次来交在你的手中，求圣灵自己在我们每一个人心里做工。我们的祈求感恩，奉主耶稣基督的圣名，阿们。耶稣在传信息，你如果教我们今天所读的圣经，你会发现有很多人来听。
As Jesus was teaching, there are several people who went to hear his teachings.
所以耶稣他就特别这阵，我离开迄个荒淡薄所在，才有人对这众人来讲道。
So he got into a boat and sat on it, by the sea, so that he can be able to address the crowd.
耶稣用真侪譬喻来教导这众人。
Jesus uses several parables to teach the people.
但一个第重要的一个譬喻，就是今仔咱所要分享的。
And one of the most important parable is the parable that we are going to discuss.
所以耶稣讲，有一日啊，有一个人去亚种子。
So Jesus said there was once a man who sowed.
这个种子有诶哦，落伫路诶边啊。
As he sowed, some seed fell along the path.
因为这个路诶边啊，土真短，所以这种子无法进入土内面。
Because the soil by the wayside is hard, so the seed cannot get into the soil.
So the birds came and devoured it. And the birds came and devoured it.
So the soil is shallow.
因为这土真浅呢，所以这种子真紧就发苗了，还是不结了。
So because of the soil is shallow, so
the seeds
become sprung up easily.
但是这种子呢是暂时的。
But these are temporary.
所以日头真艳的时阵。
So when the sun rose.
因为无根
，because there was not enough roots，
所以伊就孤单就死去了。
So it withered and died。
有第三款的土
，so the third type of soil
是有刺配的土
，is thorny soil。
因为这刺配也是长大
，because as the seed grow， the thorns also grow up。
所以这好的种子呢，袂通得到日头伫迄搭来，伫迄搭咧食。
So there was not enough sunlight for the seed.
啊，无够个营养，因为食刺配呢，将食一寡营养退去了。
And there were not enough nutrients because the thorns get all the nutrients.
所以食种子呢，也是未结果子。
So this seed does not bear fruit.
第四项，耶稣讲，但是有一寡种子哦，落地好的土。
And there are some seeds that fell on the good soil.
一些食，因为好的土呢，所有肥料，伊的土真好，所以种子伊就结实咯，有30倍、60倍、100倍。
And because these are good soil, so there are enough nutrients, and they were able to grow and produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold.
这学生因未明白耶稣咧讲的这个譬喻是什么意思啊
？The disciples did not understand what this.Parable is all about.
所以因就问耶，一无人的时阵，因就问耶稣咯。
So as they came to Jesus Christ, secretly they asked the meaning of this parable.
耶稣讲天国的奥秘哦，是托恁家庭的人，怎样就是恁家接受我的人会明白。
So Jesus told them that the mystery of the kingdom of God is revealed to those who are in the family.
咱怎样讲呢？讲到奥秘哦，奥秘的意思是啥物？
So when we talk about mystery, what is the meaning of mystery?
奧秘的意思就是在古約的時陣，人未明白到底是什麼代誌。
In the Old Testament time, they do not understand what this mystery is all about.
但是這個奧秘到我在新約的時陣就顯明出來了。
But it was revealed during the New Testament time.
這個奧秘就是講耶穌伊本身到以色列，但是以色列人拒絕伊。
The mystery is Jesus himself will come to the nation of Israel, but they will reject him.
So, Yaso, like our Isaac in the Jaku, Swadini, so it took Yan Kitsiki season. Yaso, what said it, it is Sekai, a cocktail.
So, because of the rejection of these Israelites, he was able to set his kingdom after a certain period of time.
Tansi, in Isaac the Lang, Kuzwat, or Yaso.
But because they reject Jesus Christ,
so Yaso Gong Jin Jue Dodi, he dihita Bobe to India Ebienbek.
So he uses the parable in order for them not to fully understand.
So Uelang Gong, Ani Giam Msi Jinja Bo Gong Bi Bo Lim Bin Ma.
Isn't it unjust for Jesus to do this?
Msi, Inu Yaso, I Bunsin Lai Giang Jin Jue Sindia, the Isik Lan Bin Jiang Kahuni, Tansi, In Bobe Japsu.
No, because he performs a lot of miracles and give them a lot of teachings, but they are not willing to accept it.
So, Yaso told him the reason, just because in God's word, Yaso just in Peter to in Gong.
So, because of their rejection, Jesus uses parable to teach them.
So, Yaso 讲假人会听，但是未辨别。
So, Jesus said they will hear, but they will not understand.
因会听见，但是唔知影什么意思，唔知影迄个属灵的意思。
They will.Here, but they will not comprehend the spiritual meaning of these teachings.
耶稣就解释，哦，这个譬喻的意思是什么
？So Jesus explains the parable to the disciples.
耶稣讲到迄个譬喻，伊讲有一个是亚经的，这个咧亚经就是伊将上帝话传开了。
So there was a sower. He was the one who spread the message of Jesus of God.
这个经子呢？是代表上帝的话。
The seed represents the word of God.
那个土是代表人的心。
And the soil represents the heart of people.
原来有四款的人听上帝的道理。
So there are four types of people who hears the teachings of Christ.
圣经无清楚讲那个亚经的是耶稣本身，还是一寡传道人，还是传福音的人将上帝的话传开了。
The Bible did not specifically say who that sower is. Is it Jesus or those who are preaching the gospel? But they are the one who sowed the seed.
头一款的心，哦，咱该形容做无兴趣的心。
The first kind of heart is the uninterested heart.
这无兴趣的心呢，是亲像伫路边的心，伫路边的迄个土，因的心哦真硬。
So they are like those soil on the wayside. They have a hard heart.
上帝的话，哦，一摆过一摆，托人听，但是这人拒绝。
The word of God was being preached to them several times, but they reject it.
圣经有一个真正重要的教训。
There is an important teaching in the Bible.
因为有一寡人以为讲，上帝那是听心有怜悯，哦，咱虽然直直拒绝，唔免惊。
Now they have a belief that because God is loving and just.So even if we reject, we should not be afraid.
但是圣经的教示不是安尼。
But the Bible does not teach that.
因为圣经讲耶稣虽然是吞论。
Because the Bible teaches, although God is patient.
但是一个人若一直拒绝上帝的话。
But if they keep on rejecting the word of God.
有可能到我一个时阵，上帝的话哦，未搁再对这个人。
There will come a time that the message or the word of God will no longer be preached to him. This man will not
repent. This man will not
accept. He will not accept.
Let's look at the Bible. There is a place in Hebrews 11, 6-4,
So in Hebrews chapter 6, verses 4 to 6.
Hebrews 6, 4 to 6.
Hebrews chapter 6, verses 4 to 6 says,
论到这已经忘了更久的。
For it is impossible in the case of those once been enlightened,
七个天恩的滋味,
who have tasted the heavenly gift,
各地圣灵有份,
and have shared the Holy Spirit,
并且七个上帝先道的滋味,
and have tasted the goodness of the Word of God,
觉悟这个来世关联的人,
and the powers of the age to come,
若是离去,
and they have fallen,
就不会叫他重新懊悔,
he will not restore them again to repentance.
因为因将上帝的子钉钉十字架,
since they are crucifying once again the Son of God,
明明会羞辱他,
to their own harm.
这个经文是跟我们说，这人哦, 因为得到光照, 意思因为看到亮光啊，有淡薄知影圣经的教导。
So this verse tells us that the people have already been enlightened.
因为七个天恩的滋味,
they have already tasted the heavenly gift.
意思因为经验到上帝丰盛的恩典,
they have experienced the grace of God.
并且因为经历到上帝的能力,
and they have already experienced the work of God.
但是虽然这代志安尼发生了,
even though they have experienced all this, they have neglected and rejected the word of God. This we can say are false Christians.
These
false Christians will leave the message of God. So in Hebrews, it has informed and told us that they have already rejected this opportunity that is given to them.
帮助他们哦,
so God will reject them also.
因虽然还在听到道理，未接受咯,
even if they have heard the message once again, they will not be willing to accept it.
所以我们每一个基督徒，我们要真注意哦，我们的心是什么款的心。
So we have to search our heart. What kind of safe heart do we have?
第二款的心，耶稣讲是
The second kind of heart is heart without roots.
这款的心就是拿亲像那个种子落地石头顶.
So this one is seed is being sown on the rocky ground.
因为伊的根是真，伊那个土是真正浅的.
Because the soil is shallow.
所以这个人听到道理也欢喜.
So when he heard the gospel, he was very happy.
但是拄到患难的时阵,
but when difficulties come,
受逼迫的时阵,
and there were persecutions,
他很快就跌倒了,
he easily gave up.
有第三款的心,
the third kind of heart,
这个第三款的心是我们该称作缺了的心,
we can say that this is the choked heart.
这个人, 他听到道理, 他欢喜,
this person, he has already heard the gospel and he is happy.
他也明白,
he understand it,
但是因为世界真多挂虑,
but because of the worries of life,
因为钱财哦发财会未歇,
because of money, the
influence of money. 甲圣经所讲的有真多其他的私欲,
there are the Bibles have also informed us that there are a lot of things that bother him.
因为真多这物件呢 keep in it,
because these things attract him.
所以伊就安离开.
So he left the gospel that was preached to him. He is unfruitful. Now there is the fourth type of heart. And this is a heart with a good soil. What do you mean by a good soil? What is a good heart?
听到上帝的话哦，伊伫迄搭来反应。
It is a heart that when he heard the gospel of Christ, he responded.
那亲像伫旧约哦，有一个王名做约瑟亚。
Just like the King Josiah.
当约瑟亚听到上帝话时阵
When Josiah heard the word of God,
哦，伊脱伊个衫
，He torn his clothes.
伊伫搭哀哭
，And he repented.
伊谦卑落来
，He humbled himself.
伊伫搭来顺服，哦，来敬服上帝话
，And obey the word of God.
上帝只要着先知讲约瑟亚王讲。
So the prophet told just King Josiah.
He said, 因为你谦卑你的心。
He said, because you humbled yourself.
因为哦，你听到上帝话语时阵，哦，你该接受咯。
When you heard the word of God and you accept it.
伊说，所以上帝讲，我要讲真侪遮在下头犹太国的，哦，未伫你的活爱时阵降临。
And the sufferings that the country or the nation of Israel will experience will not be during his lifetime. Because God said, you heard and you listened to my word. Let us think through what is a responsive heart. So we are going to talk about the six characteristics of a responsive heart. These characteristics should all Christians should have. Because if we don't have these six characteristics, we cannot be fruitful. So the first characteristic is develop a lifestyle habit of daily prayer. In Mark chapter 1 verse 35 it says,
天也还未光的时候，就是讲，这要透早的时候。
While it was still dark, meaning it is very early in the morning,
耶稣起来了。
Jesus departed and went out.
他就去到一个旷野，自己在那里来祈祷。
He went to a desolate place and there he prayed.
这个是耶稣的习惯。
This is the habit of Jesus.
美国有一个真正出名的传道人。
There is a famous preacher in America.
他名叫 Charles Stanley.
He is Charles Stanley.
他最近哦，过身了。
He just passed away.
但是有人问他，他说你哦，读圣经那么多道理，你觉得什么是最重要的？
So he said that you have read the Bible and you have seen all the messages. What is the most important? The most important lesson that I learned according to Dr. Charles Stanley is to pray. When I was still young, around 7 to 9 months old, my father passed away.
只有我的老母，哦，甲我。
Only my mother with me.
我的老母教啊，就用祈祷话靠上帝。
And my mom taught me that you have to pray and trust God.
伊说特别是我的老母教我讲，那暗时咯，伫床咧咧祈祷，伊说你袂用倒咧困，你袂用倒咧祈祷，伊说你着跪咧祈祷。
So his mom taught him that he has to kneel in the bed while praying.
Charles Stanley 讲，我老母托我这个习惯哦，就跪咧祈祷，我是我觉得我的老母所想受托我第一大的贡献。
So he said that this lesson that my mom gave me is the most important lesson that I got.
伊说伊较中大时阵，伊要读神学。
When he was older, he wants to go into seminary.
但是伊无钱。
But he do not have enough.
所以伊是凭着信心去报名。
And because of that, Because of his faith, he go and register.
伊伫美国个所在，伊虽然无钱哦，要读神学咯，但是伊也搁伫路顶，因为上帝感动伊，伊也伫路顶伫搭咧传福音。
So because he has not enough fund to enroll in the seminary, one time as he was preaching the word of God on the street.
伊咧传福音时阵哦，有一个牧师听到。
As he was preaching, a pastor heard him.
啊，才知影讲原来这个哦是报名去神学，但是这个人哦实在是真正双向无钱。
And he come to know that this person has already enrolled but do not have enough funds.
伊就请 Charles Stanley 去到伊个办公室，我甲伊三个讨论。
So he invited Dr. Charles Stanley to go to his office and discuss with him.
因谈妥了哦，经过两个日以后。
And after their communication, after 2 months,
Charles Stanley 收到一张批。
Dr. Charles Stanley received a letter.
原来这个牧师写批给讲。
This letter was from the pastor.
He said, "You want to study science? We want to give you this science degree. The scholarship for 4 years. We want you to apply."
So he was informing him that we are going to, they are going to sponsor him 4 years of seminary training. Whatever expenses that he will be needing will be covered.
So Charles Stanley said, "Faith is really important."
So he said that prayer is really important. He said that we alone cannot do anything. But we have to trust everything through prayer.
So this
is the most important thing that as Christians we have to learn. You may not be able to do a lot of things, but don't forget.To pray. Second, you have to humbly accept God's word. A while ago, we have already mentioned that King Josiah humbled himself and accepted the word of God. You can read this story from 2 Chronicles chapter 34, verse 27.
Thirdly,
we have to meditate on God's word. In
Joshua
chapter 1, verse 8, it says,
Moses told Joshua, he said, "This book, Lutwa, don't leave your mouth."
Moses said,This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth.
He said, "You shall read me, Sushong."
But you shall meditate on it day and night.
Why shall we read me, Sushong?
Why should we meditate on it day and night?
He said, "How do we remember or know our God's word?"
So that we may be able to understand the word of
God. You shall be careful to do according to it.
Then we will be careful to do according.
He said, "If you do this,
and if you do this,
your road will be smooth."
Your way will be prosperous.
凡事顺利。
And you will have good success.
一个人若无读上帝的话。
If a person do not read the word of God.
伊是哪亲像有土，但是迄个土无肥料。
It is like his heart is like a soil but without nutrients.
你知影讲你有土，哦，你要土你所种做的，会伫迄搭来结实，遐侪果子，头一项。
You know that for your heart or for the soil to bear fruits, you have to have nutrients. For our heart to be fruitful, then we have to read the Word of God.
So it's like fertilizer.
It's like fertilizer.
So, if you have a lot of soil, you will be able to grow.
So, because of the fertilizer, then whatever you do will be fruitful. There is a close relationship between the third and the fourth. The third, we said we have to meditate on God's word.
Because you have to meditate on God's word.
Because you meditate on God's word, you will understand what the word of God is telling us. Because you know what God wants us to do. So we will obey God's word. So the fourth is obey God's word.
We just, in the Joshua 1:8, we said, you will read me, Sushong,好好地哦，会谨守、遵行 这个律法典所写的一切的吩咐。
So as we have read earlier in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8, that we should meditate on the word of God day and night, so that we may be careful to do according to all that is written in it.
摩西咧吩咐以色列人的时阵
，When Moses was talking to the people, the Israelites.
伫新命记28章第一节。讲到相关的这个意思。
In Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1, it also tells us the same thing.
在《申命记》28章第一节，伊安尼讲。
In Deuteronomy 28 verse 1, it tells us.
伊说你哦，那是留意听探耶和华你上帝的话。
And if you faithfully obey the voice of the Lord your God.
就是讲你呐注意听。
If you listen carefully.
哦，你好好去思想。
And you think through it.
谨守遵行伊的一切的诫命
，being careful to do all his commandments。
你注意哦，其他无讲遵行淡薄，是隆重哦一切的诫命。
He didn't say some, but he said all of his commandments。
然后摩西讲，就是我今仔日所吩咐托你的
，that I command you today。
伊说你哦，会的确超乎天下万民之上。
The Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth.
相关的意思。
Same meaning.
摩西跟以色列人讲。
Moses told the Israelites.
你若注意听。
If you listen carefully.
唔是马马虎虎的。
Not half-heartedly.
唔是轻彩。
Not half-heartedly.
是真是心内真正注意咧咧听。
But religiously listening to the word of God.
你若注意读上帝话。
If you carefully read the word of God.
并且。你该遵行
，and obey it。
伊说你要会伫万百姓之上
，God will set you high above all nations。
就是讲你会成功
，meaning you will have success。
第二个
，fifth，
你要保持你的心圣洁
，keep your heart holy。
伫以赛亚书六章第三节，哦，咱真正熟的一节的经文。
In Isaiah chapter 6 verse 3, a very familiar verse.
以赛亚看到上帝时阵
，When Isaiah saw God,
哦，伊就讲圣哉，圣哉，圣哉。
He said, "Holy, holy, holy."
上帝哦，一个第重要的美德。
The most important attributes of God
就是上帝是圣洁的上帝。
Is that He is a holy God?
咱每一个人，咱阿爸。在上帝的面前，我们要会结果子，我们要成功，圣洁是未做无的。
In order for us to bear fruit, and we have to live a holy life.
大卫王伊伫诗篇五十一篇第十节，伊有伊犯罪了，伊赶紧安尼祈祷。
David in Psalm 51 verse 10, after he sinned against God, he prayed this prayer.
伊讲上帝啊，求你为我做清洁的心。
He said, "O Lord, create in me a pure heart."
咱会用讲，上帝所有的这好的美德啊，这个圣洁啊，是第一标准哦，来形容咱的上帝是什么款。
Among the attributes of God, this holiness describes God perfectly.
咱的心那是圣洁。
If our heart is pure,
你就是跟咱那个土哦，无欺骗。
It is like a soil without thorns.
你这个土无什么石头。
There are no rocks in it.
无什么咧乱做，我加种子让成长。
There are nothing hindering the growth of the seed.
咱每一个人那是活着圣洁的生活。
If we live a holy life,
并唔是讲咱袂犯罪咯。
It doesn't mean that we are not going to sin anymore.
但是是讲咱的尽咱的本分，咱若得罪上帝，咱赶紧求上帝赦免咱。
But we will.Do our best to live a holy life, and if we sin, we will ask God to forgive us. If we have this kind of life, then we are going to bear fruit.
Sixth,
trust and wait on God.
In Proverbs
chapter 3, verses 5 and 6,
Solomon said, "You are trusting in Yahweh."
King Solomon said, "If you trust the Lord wholeheartedly,
无依靠你家己的聪明
and not lean on your own understanding,
伫凡事的点面
in all your ways,
你认定上帝
acknowledge him,
上帝哦会指引 你的道路。
And he will make your path straight.
咱咧瓦靠天后上帝是哪亲像，比如说咱，我像阮厝内有种山拿树。
If we talk about trusting and waiting on God, it's like in our house we have a mango tree.
有时阵哦，咱也唔知影，哇，咱说这个树哦，哇，番侪只山拿咯。
So we said that, oh, this tree bears a lot of mangoes.
我一个厝边哦，伊对种个种作也熟。
So my neighbor is familiar with this.
这几日前哦，伊甲我讲。
So he told me one time.
伊说你在种个山拿树啊，遐果子那是未熟哦，想你想早该搬落来。
He said that if these mango trees, the fruit are not yet ripe, and you take it out.
伊说：“你搬落来哦，你发现哦，你家徛咧边啊，熟的时阵哦，会也侪乌点，也侪乌乌的所在。
”So after harvesting, you will notice that when it ripened, there are a lot of big black dots.
啊，我说原来是安尼哦。
So I said, "Oh, it's like this."
我说我早有时啊，看到时啊，阮只工人哦，会挽一寡山用个山那土棍哦，但是无偌久到我熟时阵哦。哦，也侪乌乌的所在。
So I noticed that when our house help harvest some of the mangoes, when it ripened, they have a lot of black dots.
原来哦，想早该搬落来。
So the reason is because we harvest it too early.
就是哪亲像咱基督徒
，just like Christians.
上帝时间未到。
When God's time has not yet arrived.
但是咱哦也急。
But we are not willing to wait.
咱无要听候上帝的时间
，not willing to wait for the time of God。
所以真侪代志哦，冲袂好势。
So a lot of things that we do will not be able to do properly。
哦，咱对主了解，我看上帝创造，咱有法学真侪属灵的功课。
From the nature, the creation of God, we can learn a lot of things。
现在咱来看咱第三个大啊，我重点要讲的是圣经。哦，关于亚种甲收割的一寡教训，圣经有真侪教训，但是咱有拣三个，咱来啊四个，咱通来分享。
So the third main point that we are going to have is the biblical teaching on sowing and reaping.
头一个教训哦，就是讲，你若少种就少收，你若多种就多收。
Sow sparingly.Reap sparingly, sow bountifully, reap bountifully.
你若也真侪种子，哦，你的收成也是也多。
If you sow a lot of seeds, then you will be able to reap a lot.
你若也的种子也少，哦，你的收成也是也少。
But if you sow a little seed, then you will also reap a little.
这个是哪真像咱跟随上帝。
This is just like how we follow the Lord.
哦，咱甘愿投资。咱的时间
，If we are willing to invest our time，
哦，咱的金钱
，our money，
咱的能力
，our resources，
因为咱甘愿托上帝用
，because we want to allow God to use them，
所以上帝用咱所有的，我伫迄搭加倍享受托咱
，so God uses and continue to bless us。
哦，我捌几年前哦，家己甲上帝讲
，a few years ago I have talked。With God.
我讲上帝啊，你知影我已经退休咯。
I told him that, Lord, I am already retired.
所以唔是亲像少年人哦，也好真侪能力咧。
Not like the young people who still have enough strength.
啊，无法亲像种个少年人哦，也好真够投资咧。
Or they are good in investing.
但是我讲上帝啊，虽然哦。按照着你头想收头啊，伊说，但是我也要凭信心哦。我本来那是奉献十分之一，我现在要来奉献十分之二，哦，意思20%奉献头你。
So by faith I said that Lord, if before I'm offering 10%, now I'm willing to give 20%.
我家己想袂到哦，安尼创了时阵。
I didn't realize that after I prayed this.
我看到上帝家己带领后，对真侪其他我想无的哦。上帝伫搭倒想出头啊
！God has used several ways to bless me。
所以我才知影哦，这个上帝的教训是有影的。
Then I realized that the teaching of God is true。
哦，咱若做做种，做做收。
If we sow bountifully, we reap bountifully。
哦 ，Rick Warren 伊也做这个见证。
Rick Warren also said, give this
Rick
kind
Warren
of testimony.
Rick Warren 讲伊头头伊也个真少，伊趁食真少时阵咯，伊是奉献十分之。
He said that while his income is still minimal, he offered 10%.
但是伊讲伊本身伊继续哦增加伊个奉献。
But he continued to increase his offering.
伊说到啊最近哦，伊已经奉献嘞，已经是90%咯。
And now he is offering 90%.
意思伊若赚100,000，伊是奉献90,000托上帝。
So if he is giving 10,000, if he is earning 100,000, then he is giving 90,000 to God.
你想看卖哦 ，Rick Warren 啊，伊是一个牧师啊。
You may think that Rick Warren is a pastor.
哦，但是伊也是甘愿投资哦，上帝的国度。
But he is willing to invest in the kingdom of God.
So, we know Rick Warren.
So, for those who know Rick Warren,
Rick Warren has written a book.
He has written a book.
A purpose-driven life.
A purpose-driven life.
This book, purpose-driven life, the whole world.
This book was printed in the whole world.
He only wrote the book he wrote, and the funds.已经算不了了。
The money that he earned from this book is a lot.
伊所得到的，伊说伊那是家己要用哦，伊有法退休哦，去到一个真正水的都市，家己伫迄搭哦，请真侪人，哦，逐日逐日咧家赢，伊免做工。伊说上帝是安尼宽大，想死头伊的。
He said that the earnings of the book will be able to give him a good retirement.With people ministering or serving him.
圣经讲到亚种甲收割第二个教训。
The second lesson that we can learn from sowing and reaping.
你种的是什么哦？你收的也是什么
？You reap what you sow.
假使你哦对人无客气
，If you are not good with other people.
哦，你无礼数
，You are not respectful.
所以经常哦人会反应呢，也是相款。
The other people will also treat you that way.
但是你呐，比如说你对人较有尊重嘞。
But if you show respect to other people,
你较免咧甲别人爱计较。
You don't want to
complain.
Complain.
啊，你也无咧爱直直甲别人冤家。
Or argue with other people.
哦，你会帮衬人。
You are willing to help.
上帝家己伫这个自然律哦，会托你拄到假人。因也是相款，我对你会较好。
Naturally, you will also receive that kind of people.
所以你呐，假使哦，你伫迄搭奉唱你的情欲
，If you want to do what you want to do,
哦，你会对肉体伫迄搭修行败坏。
You will also reap what you have done.
但是你呐，伫上帝。国度里面
，But in God's kingdom，
哦，你伫迄搭是来压好的种子
，You sow good seeds，
哦，你会得到上帝哦，永生赏赐予你
，You will receive the eternal reward of God。
第三个教训
，The third lesson，
伊说你唔通灰心哦，丧志，因为到了时阵你要修行
，Do not be weary and give up。In due time, you will reap.
咱知影讲，亲像圣经所讲的约瑟。
From the story of Joseph.
约瑟虽然哦受真侪人伫迄搭哦来对伊无好势来出卖。
Although Joseph was maltreated and being sold.
哦，伊家己的兄弟出卖。
His brothers sold him.
伊伫这个波提法的厝内做工，哦，迄个太太冲讲伊。
While he is serving in the house of Potiphar, his mistress maltreated her and him, and he was imprisoned.
但是伊并无灰心
But he did not grow weary.
所以到时呢，上帝就高估伊了
And in due time, God raised him up.
伊设立哦，伫埃及，伊变做伫迄个埃及法老王的下面，伊变做宰相。
And he became the prime minister of Egypt.
第四个教训
The fourth lesson.
伊说咱着辛苦，哦，上帝也正，唔通看环境行行。
Trust God and soul. Do not look at circumstances and become afraid.
在团道书第十一章第四节，安尼讲。
In Ecclesiastes 11 verse 4 it says,
是一个人哦，那是咧看风。
He who observes the wind,
伊袂去亚精。
Will not sow.
一个人那是观看云，伊袂伫迄搭来收割。
And he who regards the clouds will not reap.
意思就是讲，你一个人哦，你若要等啊到达行到完完全全咯。
Meaning that if that person or a person is waiting for perfection, then he will be paralyzed
of his potential. 这个完全哦，伊会拖咱的潜能麻痹。
So this perfection will paralyze us of our potential.
就是真侪人，你若伫咧要听下到，当着完全咯，哦，着无虾米问题咯，你才要团落金，你永远袂团落金。
So if a person will wait for the most perfect timing, preparation and everything to preach the gospel, then we will not be able to preach the gospel.
今仔日，我们分享简单的信息。
Today, we have shared the word of God.
咱讲到亚精的譬喻。
We talk about the parable of the sower in the seed.
咱讲到四款的土。
We talk about the four kinds of soil.
讲四款的心。
Four kinds of heart.
是好的心，才会结果子。
The good heart will bear fruit.
咱来分享讲，这个好的心，就有什么款的性质。
And we have discussed the characteristics of a responsive heart.
咱讲这个好的心呢，这个人伊在世是独立有读圣经的习惯。
So we can say that this person will have a daily habit of studying the Word of God.
He is
humble to accept the Word of God. Meditate on His Word. Obey the Word of God. He will maintain purity. And He will wait and trust God.
After we talk about收割甲亚种的一寡教训。
And we have talked about the teachings of sowing and reaping.
你若要收成多，你亚的也得多。
If we want to reap bountifully, then we have to sow bountifully.
啊，上帝是袂受咱欺骗的。
God will not lie to us.
所以你若种什么，你就要收什么。
Whatever you reap, that you will sow.
唔通灰心丧志，哦，你着持守。因为到时你就要收成咯。
Do not be weary and give up, because in due time we will reap.
你要信靠上帝，你唔通爱看环境，才要传福音。
Trust God and do not look at the circumstances before we preach the word of God.
咱来阿头三个祈祷。
Let's pray. 特别上帝，阮感谢你，因为接到今仔日早起的这个披露，会通帮助阮明白，出阮那底下的。传福音的时阵，欠债有阵啊，未大家人接受你做因固定的救主，但是帮助阮未通继续坚持，或阮未通继续忠心的来做主的工。恩望讲主，阮家己也是陪伴阮的心，未通真做一个好的徒，愿意底下来领受主的话语，也愿意底下来遵行，活出一个得胜的生命。求主你继续帮助阮，祝福阮，未通伫你的驾驶顶面。看起到主，阮应该着怎啊有对的态度，伫遐来亚精，啊，互阮会晓要怎啊尽阮所有的来献予你。咱望讲主，阮投资伫你的国度的物件，袂通得着主你的喜悦。我主耶稣基督的圣名。
阿门。
多谢陈俊祥长老、陈刚先生、高启立长老来帮阵翻译。网络顶的兄弟姊妹，今仔早起的崇拜会到这为止，多谢。现在请陈俊祥长老来带领咱